Hello everyone, good morning. Yeah, this morning, before conducting the boss meeting, I need to do a morning round check in the engine room as a chief engineer. On this shift, among the systems that reduce the anodic emission, exogas recirculation system, EGR, and the acidic catalytic reduction system, SCR, installed. Okay, come along with me and take a round check together. Since we are going to enter the engine room from the changing room, we will wear the necessary PPE first. What we are seeing now is the generator engine's exhaust bypass. When SCR is not in use, exhaust gases are directly released into the atmosphere. When SCR is in use, the gases pass through the catalytic chamber before being released into the atmosphere. In this vessel, main engine cylinder 1 is supplied by gravity. So, cylinder 1 service tank level must be regularly checked. What we see now is the exhaust gas economizer, which is part of the weak heat recovery system's huge combo. By looking at the manometer of the economizer, we can determine whether smooth cycling is necessary or not. Water level gauge is installed on the boiler to indicate whether water is present. It is essential to observe and check this during round checks. Let's move up to the upper deck. What we see now are the catalytic chambers used in the generator SCR systems. We can check whether the catalytic chamber is clogged by looking at the inlet and outlet pressure of the catalytic chamber. Over here is the thermal part of the boiler. As seen, 4 safety bolts are installed. Currently, boiler is not running due to low steam consumption. When the boiler is firing, it's important to observe the flame color, flame stability, and smoke color for proper inspection. Here, we also have to inspect for steam leakage and fuel oil leakage. This boiler is a manual boiler, capable of producing steam pressure up to about 0.90 MPa. A freshwater expansion tank is constructed to provide cooling water for the main engine, auxiliary engines, main compressors, and BWTS system. Typically, expansion tank is installed at the highest point of the engine room. Air needed for boiler combustion is supplied by the full draft fan. As the ship gets older, expansion joint and the air tends to deteriorate, so this must be carefully checked during round checks. Boiler water circulation pumps are used to draw water from the boiler and circulate it into the economizer tubes. Fuel supply and circulation pumps and tire models must be regularly checked. This is the effort level bulbous fuel filter. Although it operates automatically, if the filter is clogged, the red indicator will be fully raised. Currently, filter is in normal condition. Jack filter must also be checked to see whether the cleaning pan is continuous running, whether the cleaning pan light is normal, and whether the alarm indicator is on. Fuel settling tanks and service tanks should be checked with the attention to dial levels. Additionally, tanks should be regularly drained, and any water or sludge at the bottom of the fuel tanks must be removed. Let's go over and check the site. This is the northern unit of the generator SCR system. At present, SCR system is not in use. Since this ship is a chemical tanker, nitrogen generator is an essential piece of machinery. On some ships, nitrogen generator is installed in a separate compartment, but here it is installed inside the engine room. There are two types, air seal and membrane, and the one we see now is the membrane type. The membrane type is more compact than air seal, although it cannot produce nitrogen of at high purity as ESA. It can still generate nitrogen with up to 99.5% purity. What we see ahead are two nitrogen compressors. Their capacities vary slightly. This is the manual incinerator. It is used to incinerate sludge from the engine room, oily rats, and even some domestic garbage like paper. In older ships, the incinerator must be operated for longer periods to manage sludge properly. Over here is the dead air compressor. It provides compressed air for maintenance work on the deck. On this ship, compressed air from the dead air reservoir is also used for the SCR catalytic soup blowing. Let's continue forward. The engine room crane is used during main engine maintenance to lift heavy components. This is engine room cavity station. Waste must be sorted by type and not mixed together. Let's go into the engine room workshop. Proper PPE must be readily available for using grinding and drilling machines. Also, emergency stop for switches should be regularly inspected. This is the designated howard area. On tanker ships, if howard is to be done outside the workshop, office approval must be obtained. Let's go down to see what's below. This is the emergency air reservoir, used to restart generator engines in emergency situations. On this ship, there's a dedicated emergency air compressor. On some ships, one of the two main air compressors serves as the emergency air compressor. Generator lubricant purifier is used to clean the generator somewhat. It can also be used to clean lubricant from the lubricant storage tank. Main generators supplying the power required for both ship operations and cargo operations. This is the urea dosing pump, which automatically dose the required urea when the SCR system is in use. While our feed water pumps draw water from the cascade tank and supply this to the boiler. Most tanker vessels use Framo cargo pumps. High pressure hydraulic wine needed for operating cargo and ballast pumps is supplied from this system. This is the test bench for testing fuel injectors from the main and generator engines. This is the isobar grinding machine used for grinding the grooves on the main engine isobars and bar seats. This is dismantling stand. These are spare isobars, cylinder liner, and piston for the main engine. The control panel and capacitor bands of the VWDS system are also installed inside the engine room. That is not ideal, At high internal temperature can cause error in electronic circuits inside the PWDS control panel. Let's head on to look at the head of the ship, the main engine. The main engine installed is the J engine, model 6UEC 42LSE1 Eco T3, which is fully electronically controlled. It is a Tier 3 type engine. Unlike conventional engines, each unit is fitted with 3 fuel injectors. This main engine uses exhaust gas recirculation system, EGR, one of the methods for reducing anodized emissions. Propulsion is still mechanical. During round checks, the area around the propulsion should be inspected for abrasive metal particles and shifted markings. Since the vessel is in port, raw sewage cannot be directly discharged into the sea. Therefore, an approved sewage treatment plant is used. UV lamp must be turned on. Aeration blower must be running. And any abnormalities must be checked. Over here are two main air compressors. They supply compressed air for starting the main and auxiliary engines and for other services. This is the freshwater and drinking water hydrophone systems. It supplies fresh and drinking water at constant pressure to accommodation areas. Water level and compressed air ratio in the tank must be adjusted accordingly using the lever gauge. This is the generator engine's jacket water cooler. If the cooler is dirty, jacket temperature of the running generator engine can increase. Impedance covering cathodic protection system must be turned off while in port or when the ship is in fresh water. In the electronic control main engine, system windings we use at hydraulic wire. An auto bubble bowl fitter is installed in the hydraulic wire line. This is the emergency locus stand used when the main engine cannot be controlled remotely. These are the bands that supply slender wire. They are similar to the FR lubricator. This main engine's hydraulic line doesn't have accumulators, so pressure fluctuations are more significant. Motor driving hydraulic wire pans supply wire only during main engine starting and up to a certain engine load. Once the engine reaches a set RPM in load, engine driving pumps take over and the motor driving stop. These are the panels for the oxygen sensors installed in the EGR system. Before starting the EGR system, the oxygen sensors must be calibrated. Okay, let's continue our starting. This is the sodium hydroxide tank, which automatically dose as needed to maintain the pH of the EGR scalding water at 7. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notification bell for upcoming contents. To generate fresh water from seawater on board, fresh water generator is used. Main engine jacket cooling water heat is used for seawater evaporation. This is an effort level aqua blue series unit, capable of producing about 15 tons of fresh water per day. This is about 15,000 liters. Okay, let's continue downward. This is the main engine turning gear. Since the engine is stopped, turning gear is currently engaged. A fuel wine leakout tank with a high-level sensor is installed to detect abnormal fuel wine leakage from the main engine. Engine-driven hydraulic pumps are housed in the casing we see now. Over here is the lubricant purifier used to clean the main engine system-wide. Standard lubricant pumps and dial motors must also be checked regularly. When one pump is running, others should be in standby mode. That way, if the running one stops unexpectedly, the standby can automatically take over and continue while supply. A sharp grounding device is installed to prevent spark erosion on the bearings. Base wells are clean with no sign of lubricant or fuel oil. Position of the emergency fire pump suction valve must also be checked. If it is left open, seawater in the line could be lost, and priming may be required when restarting the emergency fire pump. This is the oily water separator, which separates oil and water from base water and discharges clean water overboard. It's one of the essential pieces of MOE equipment. Okay, let's continue forward. When purifying scrubbing water through a separator, sludge is produced. That sludge is stored in the holding tank, and during show discharge, a pan is used to transport it. Emergency base suction is used when the engine room flaps and normal water control methods fail. There are two types of seawater sessions, high sea chill and low sea chill. And this one is the high sea chill side. For the EGR systems scrubbing water, ship domestic water can be used for topping up. And skimmish drain condensate water can also be reused. There are two main fire pumps installed in the engine room. Emergency fire pump is installed outside the engine room. This small pump is the ejector pump. It supplies seawater needed for the freshwater generator operation. On area, often mixed during round trips at the emergency escape trap. Inside the escape trap, the condition of the emergency lights and lifting pulley must be inspected. Since almost all round checks are complete, let's proceed to the toolbox meeting and discuss today's working plan. If you found this video helpful in any way, don't forget to like it. Subscribe and stay updated with more videos from this channel.